No man say, I can't do what you can do.
What?
Man, I can't do what y'all can do. You can do anything you set your mind to. All it is a decision. Once you make your mind up to do it, challenge yourself until you accomplish that goal. Is it really that simple? Yeah, this your boy Deion Sylvester, man. I'm just coming to y'all once again. It's my time to say thank you. I appreciate y'all tuning in to me. You know, I come and I do my little quirky things. I might come in and just hit you something upside the head with like a, you know, hey, what's up? Because that's my little weak little sound effect. So that's what I got, and that's what I use. But man, I appreciate y'all for hanging out with me. And you know, people, when the negativity come, when the cup be half full, you gotta eliminate that stinking thinking. What I was taught, that's what it was called. You know, stinking thinking. You know, when somebody says you can't, they limiting you. And who are they to limit you? Ooh. I mean, that was a sentence. I don't know if that was a bar, but who are they to limit you? You have a thought process that told you you can achieve what you want to achieve. And the minute that I can't comes out of your mouth, then you've limited yourself. But don't let the next person tell you you can't do something. That should be your fuel to do it. You know, and I was told I can't quite a few times. But when I hear it, it's a challenge. It's you just, you know, took the AC Delcos out of the trunk and you put them on a battery cable and you just and charged me up. I'm going to do it. I'm going to accomplish that goal. And through accomplishing that goal, you're going to bump into some challenges. And when you bump into those challenges, that's where a lot of people quit and give up, because they're faced with challenges. Life is a challenge, man. You set a goal, you're going to go through some heartaches and pains going through it. But don't stop till you get there. And when you get there and you accomplish it, man, guess what happens? You set another one. And you continue to achieve on life. And look at the cup, always half full. Eventually, it's going to run it over. It's going to be one of the two. You're going to have a half full, half empty cup, or it's going to be running though. Man, how can you say that, man? My cup will be empty. Ah! Your cup will never be empty. Never. Never. You're going to accomplish it. You're going to reach it. You're going to make it happen. Eliminate the stinking thinking. Always be in solution mode. You know, in the industry that I work in, you know, as a supervisor, people, they, I mean, I've talked to people who've been 90 days past due on their vehicles. And they're up to be repossessed, and they're calling like, man, you guys are going to repossess my car. I can't believe this. I mean, I just need two more days. You know, I can't believe it. You can't give me two more days? Man, today Wednesday, I get paid Friday. Y'all can't give me two more days to come up with the money? Come on, man. And the reality of it, the half cup, half empty, half cup, half full theory is, all we asking you for is for 30 days of payment. You haven't paid in 90. Just pay us for 30. We won't come to pick up the car. Just meet us at 30. Man, man, y'all can't work with us nowhere. You, sir, ma'am, you still have the car, right? Yeah. And there are multiple ways out here that you can use the car to make income, like, you know, the Instacart, the Uber. Well, I didn't know that you could. That's why I'm explaining to you, there's a way that you could have done these things to make the income, to make money, and you had 90 days to do it, and all we're asking you is for 30. So I'm just trying to help them be, you can't. No, it's not that. What can you do? Be in solution mode. You know, if you in solution mode, you're thinking in half full mode. If you always focusing on a problem, you're thinking in half empty mode. It's one or the two. And if you stay thinking whatever problem and issue is coming in your way, celebratory, happy, sad, if you take it when it hits you, no matter what language it is, because if somebody came to you with drama in a language you didn't understand, you're going to look at them crazy and it's not going to affect you. So let it get you first, so you can comprehend it. Once you comprehend it, now look at it at a half full vision from a half full point of view. And that's the solution mode with everything that you can deal with. That's how you eliminate the stinking thinking. If you, whatever you beaming, your sunlight, when it's coming out, whatever you are delivering out to people, you're giving it from a half full perspective. That's how they got to accept it, because you're giving it from a half full perspective. When somebody's giving you negative, they're like, oh man, this happened. You know, people talk negative about other people. This, that, and the other. The way that it hits you, they sending it from a negative perspective, but you're receiving it at a half full perspective when you get it. So when you feed back, like, it's not like that though. Why you gotta be mad about it? What you should do in the situation is, have you thought about this? And see what I'm saying? That's how a person that's in the half full, that positive mindset, the eliminated stinking thinking, that's how they stay positive in their life, in their spiritual, in their family, in their business, in their friendships. That's how they always have friends. That's how they have very little enemies. That's why they're able to figure things out. That's why they move up on the upper epsilon in corporate America. That's why they start businesses and have people running them that understand when they build the system which way they're going. That's who you want to align yourself with. That's where you want to go. So you want to align with that half full until the cup runs over group. That's our inner circle. That the inner circle is the half full thought process till our cup runneth over. And what we are introducing to the United States right now in the fintech lane, what we're introducing is so positive. It's lives is just going to be blessed, and the cups are just going to runneth over what we are introducing people to. I mean, you're talking 100 million in sales in the next 2 years, 100,000 new people introduced to this industry that have no clue of what the industry is yet, but they do, because they're already involved in finances, they're already involved in technology, already involved in the social media platform, already in it, but haven't been introduced to the industry yet. And that's what we're doing through our inner circle. We're about to align people or position them right before it explodes, so you all can take advantage of it. In your next 2 years, the couple runneth over. So take an invitation to the inner circle. Click the link, winwithdeon.com. Go to it right now. Go through the steps and see yourself in a circle. It's definitely something that if you are a cup runneth over, positive mindset and individual, business oriented, experienced in business, novice in business, or brand new, but just want to learn what it takes, we got systems in place that's going to show you exactly what you need to do to be successful and line yourself up with this industry before the lights come on. Because right now, yeah. All right, well, I appreciate you guys sharing your time with me again. This is your boy, Deon Sylvester. Remember, we're eliminating the stinking thinking. It's out of here, and we out. So with that being said, you about to too. I'm a real hustle, I know what to do. I'm gonna flip the paper and set you cool. I'm a real hustle like 30 up. I'm a street food, I'm a man that we've been green up. I'm a real hustle, I take risk. Yeah, I'll see y'all next time, man. I appreciate y'all hanging out with me. Click the link. Make sure you get down, winwithdeon.com. Join the inner circle. So check out the information, man. Get plugged in. That's what we're doing. You know what to do.